Hey, and welcome to Girl Be Free, a podcast designed to help women get unstuck and cultivate the life you want on your terms. I'm Siobhan, your host, and I'm passionate about empowering women to live their best life. Each week, you'll hear pep talks that will inspire and push you to take action so you too can start to be free and live the life you want. You can learn more about me at befreeproject.com. Now let's jump into the show. This episode of the Girl Be Free podcast is being sponsored by the Be Free Inner Circle, an exclusive online community where positive, like-minded women gather, connect, support, and learn how to cultivate the life they deserve. The Be Free Inner Circle membership includes live monthly group coaching calls and office hours, masterclasses and workshops that will cover topics such as consistency and discipline, self-care, and creating a vision for your life, just to name a few. A resource library where you can print out articles, worksheets, and workbooks. A book club so that we have a space to discuss some of our favorite books. And the most important part is accountability and community support from women who are on the same wavelength as you and that are on a similar path who wants to be free. And a bonus feature, every member of the Be Free Inner Circle will have access to my live, in-person, monthly Be Free meetups where you'll be able to view live stream right from your computer screen. So I know you're excited and you want to be a part of the Be Free Inner Circle. So don't worry, I got you covered. Just go to befreeinnercircle.com to learn more and sign up today. Hey, hey, welcome back to the Girl Be Free podcast. I'm your host, Siobhan, where I am going to inspire you and push you to show up for yourself. Hey, y'all, I am back. I took a much needed break for the month of June just to kind of relax and chill and do some other things. So I hope you've been enjoying the rebroadcast of some of my favorite episodes. And now I am back to kick off some new content for you guys. So make sure you are sharing the podcast with your friends, tweeting it out, sharing it in your Instagram stories, or even texting the link to your friends and say, hey, girl, you need to listen. All right. So as always, let me start off with what I am loving this month. And can y'all believe it's July? Like, seriously. But what I am enjoying is thrifting. I went thrifting actually yesterday with one of my really best friends, Erica. And let me tell you this first. I am not someone who can thrift on her own. I need to be with someone else, in particular Erica, because she's really good at thrifting and helping me find good things. I have tried to go on my own and I can't find anything cute. But when I go with her, I clean up. So I found so many cute things yesterday and I cannot wait to wear them. So thrifting is what I am loving right now. I also found my kids some cool things as well. So that is what I am loving. Also, I am loving the beautiful warm weather. So I don't know if I shared this before, but summer is my favorite season and I love the hot weather. It's been in the high 90s where I'm at in Cleveland, but I have been enjoying it and I don't want it to ever go away. So that's something else that I'm loving. All right, on to today's topic, which is my simple guide to self-care. So self-care is really personal, right? It's basically how you take care of you. It's you putting you first in every way possible, always. And self-care is going to look different for each one of us because how I practice self-care and how you do it is going to look very different. But it is very, very, very important. And self-care is more than retail therapy or getting your bi-weekly mani-pedi or getting your hair done. Like, it's more to it than that. When I talk about self-care, it's more so from the emotional, mental, physical practices that you put in place to take care of yourself. And so what I'm going to share with you now is some practical things that I am doing in my life to practice self-care. I hope, make sure you have your notebook and pen out so you can take notes, and you can always share your notes with me if you choose to on Instagram by just tagging me at Be Free Project. But yes, make sure you're taking notes, and I hope that something that I share will resonate with you and give you some ideas of some other things that you can do to start to take care of yourself outside of the things that are very trendy, like I said, of the mani and pedi, getting your hair done and going shopping. So, and intentionally this week, I did number them. So number one is taking breaks. So as I mentioned in the very beginning of this episode, I took a break off from podcasting for the month of June. And that was very good, especially because I was in the middle of launching the Be Free Inner Circle, which is my membership site. And I wanted to make sure that I gave that a nice amount of attention and got into full swing with that and not having too many things on my plate. So I said I was going to take off the month just from podcasting so that I can put my energy there. And now that I have a good flow of how the membership is working, now I can bring podcasting back, right? And so not just with that, but I'm looking at my life in general. So my friend Brittany, she goes by B-Fails. You can follow her on Instagram, or she used to go by the branding bestie, but she's now B-Fails. She has this practice of a 4-hour work day, and she shared it with me she shared it with us at the Be Free meetup, but she also shared it with me personally. And I'm like, I really like that idea. And so what I've been doing is writing like a master list of everything that needs to get done for the week. And then for each task, giving it a day that I'm going to work on it. And then once I'm done, I'm done. So this way I can still enjoy my family. I can enjoy this beautiful weather. And then also I'm being productive by not putting too many things on my plate to do at once. So that has been really working well for me and is helping me take breaks and just live life while I build this amazing business. So my suggestion for you is to give yourself permission to take breaks, right? So if you're someone that works a 9-to-5, maybe once a month or once every couple of months, take a mental health day or a mental day off from work where you can just take time away, do something you want to do. Don't tell nobody you're taking a day off because, you know, people will put everything on your calendar if you do that. But yeah, take a mental day off from work. Maybe in the evenings you carve out time to just do something for you. But we all need breaks so that our mind can breathe and also so the creative juices can flow. So make sure you're doing that. Number two is, and again, these are all personal for me, so this is what I'm sharing with you. Go and move at your own pace. So I have to remind myself very often that there's no rush, that I need to enjoy the process of growing and evolving. And that's in my business, that's in my personal life, like enjoying the process and pacing myself and not feeling like I have to rush and do all the things. Because when I do that, that's when my anxiety gets high. That's when I start to feel stressed out and overwhelmed. So I'm giving myself permission to just move at my own pace. That means that I can't look at what other people are doing and wanting things to happen faster for me. No, I need to embrace the time that is taking me to move throughout this world, right? And not look at what other people are doing and wanting that. And what I've been telling myself is that, and I don't know if I said this on a podcast before, but I want to make sure that I'm enjoying the process of the pace that everything is moving right now, because there's going to be a time, and mark my very words, there's going to be a time where things are going to pick up in my business and things are going to just be, everything amazing is going to be coming my way. And I know that when I get in that moment, I'm going to wish that things were a little bit slower, right? So what I am feeding my mind is that enjoy this process, enjoy the pace that you're going at right now, because when business starts booming and when things start picking up and sponsorships and events and speaking and all the things that I want to do and create, it's going to happen for me. So I want to make sure that I'm just being grateful for the space that I'm in, because I'm going to wish that I had that once things start to pick up. All right. Number three. And this is probably the most important to me. Do more of what makes you come alive. So I've been purging and reflecting and letting go of things that don't that are not growing in my life. And again, that affects that affects every single area, right? And so, but in particular, my business. So now I feel like everything is in flow, I should say. So now I am very, I guess, strategic in how I move, because everything that I'm doing, I want to do, and it makes me come alive. So I'll give you an example. I launched the Be Free Inner Circle, which is my online membership site, which is a collective of positive, like-minded women, all there for one goal: to help each other get unstuck and be free to live their best life, right? So that's one piece. Then every month I have my monthly Be Free meetups, where I'm able to engage with women in person and have a collective group of women around me that we can literally pour into each other and help each other get to the next level. Then I have my speaking, so being able to go to different conferences, seminars, things like that, and have these events where I'm able to speak. So everything that I'm doing right now is what I want to do, and I'm doing them at a pace that I want to do them, and everything that I'm doing makes me come alive. And it took me a while to get to this space, because any entrepreneurs out there, you know, like, you can look at what other people are doing and you're like, oh, maybe I should be doing that, or maybe I should be doing this thing. And then you get to a place that it doesn't work, because you're not supposed to be doing it. You have to figure out how to do things your way, in a way that makes you feel good inside. So even when I launched the Be Free Inner Circle, I did it the way that I wanted to do it, right? Not with all the pressure from the internet gurus, but I did it the way that I wanted to do it. And it feels good. It's growing like I wanted to grow. So do more of what makes you come alive. Do more of what lights you up inside. And if it doesn't, then you have to do some self-reflection and figure out, why are you doing it? And what can you let go of so that you can be able to grow in a way that feels good to you? And I will say this, it is very easy, and I'm speaking from experience, to get caught up in what other people are doing and then listening to what people say you should do about your life. And then you get so confused because you're doing all these different things and then you don't know what you want. So make a decision, and I want you to write this down, that you are going to do things how you want to do them, right? And you're not going to listen to naysayers, and you're not going to listen to people tell you how to run your life. You're going to figure out how to do that for yourself. Because in reality, nobody can tell you how to live life. This is your life. This is your experience. So it's up to you to not listen to everybody else and figure out how you want to do them in a way that feels good to you. So do you, period. Okay. Next, create rituals. So this is number 4, create rituals. So for the past, I think I'm a little over 2 months now, I believe, I've been doing a morning ritual where I get up at 5 a.m. and I have certain practices that I do every single morning. And if you haven't listened to that episode of the Girl Be Free podcast, go back and listen to how I created a morning ritual for myself. But some of the things that I do every single day is I meditate. I now practice yoga in the morning, and I use the, and I'll put a link to this in the show notes, but Yoga by Adrian, I really like her in the morning. I burn incense, I burn Palo Santo, I burn sage, I read something inspirational. So that is like practices that, or rituals that I put in place. And that's me literally caring for myself before I give myself to the world. So your ritual can look similar. It can look completely different, but find something that you can do that you create a new habit. So now I have my alarm set for 5 a.m. and my body is now used to it, because I've been doing it for a couple of months now. But definitely find you a ritual that's going to work for you. And again, you can go back and listen to the episode of the where I did one specifically on how to do that. Number 5 is to surround yourself with people who match your energy. I talk about this. I know I've talked about this a number of times on the podcast, of just having the right kind of people around you that's going to add value to your life. And that is very, very important. And that's definitely self-care. So I have certain friends that I connect with that I know when I get to them, get around them, it's going to be a great laugh. I have other friends that's going to challenge me to level up and show up in my business. I have other friends where I can just let my hair down and just be vulnerable and transparent and all that stuff. And everyone in my life, including my husband, adds so much value to my life, and everyone matches my energy, right? In a way that feels good to me and what I need. And that is self-care for me, all right? So make sure that you're surrounding yourself with people who want to see you win as much as they want to win. And if you need a community, or maybe you don't have anyone in real life, definitely consider joining the Be Free Inner Circle, because I can guarantee there are women in the group that's going to show up. They're going to encourage you. They're going to motivate you. And you're going to be surrounded by just amazing women. So definitely look into that. Number six is to be mindful and self-aware. So I know because I've been meditating consecutively for, I believe today is like day 92 days that I've meditated. I am being more mindful and more self-aware. And that is self-care to me, because that allows me to check in and start to do the self-work. So whenever I notice that I'm off, or maybe I'm just not at the level that I want to be, like in my spiritual practice or whatever, I'm able to look within because I'm self-aware and put the right things in place to do the self-work. And there's also a podcast episode on that as well about doing the self-work. And there's lots of resources if you need help. So you just have to scroll back. Number seven is to live intentional and on purpose. So what I mean by that is just being intentional about how I want to show up in the world, and putting that out into the universe and expecting good to come back to me, right? So today my intention is to have more clarity and to be more energetic and then productive and focused. So that's the energy that I'm putting out in the world. That's the intention, that my expectation is that I will be able to live out that intention, as well as being in purpose. So I talk about purpose all the time. That's very important, that the work that I'm doing and the life that I'm living, I am in purpose. And that is self-care to me, because I feel so connected with self, because I'm living out my life the way that I choose to. And then number eight, which this is the last one, which is being good to my body. So what I mean by that is movement, like having more movement. So going for walks and bike rides, or going for a run, practicing yoga, that is all self-care, right? And taking care of my body first. And then also eating good, fresh food. So I love to eat, and I love when I'm eating good food. And then lastly, drinking a lot of water. So my best friend and I, first we decided to, you know, set up this ritual together where we woke up at 5 a.m. And now that that has become a habit and we're good, now we decided to add something else. And so the challenge, or the new habit that we're putting in place, is drinking more water. So I've read in a number of different places that you're supposed to drink half of your body weight per day in water. And y'all, that's a lot of water. So I downloaded this app. I'll link it in the show notes in case anyone wants to download it, so that I can keep track of it, of my water intake. And so every day I am drinking a lot of water. And at the end of the day, we just have to text each other and say, hey, I got my daily water intake. And so again, that's that accountability. That's me taking care of myself, because I need to drink more water. And that is a beautiful thing. So hopefully that was helpful, and that gives you some more ideas as it relates to practicing self-care, like in a way that's not so the traditional things or the trendy things that you hear, but practical things that I'm actually doing that are all self-care practices for me. So your action step this week is to create your own self-care practice. So you can use my list as an example. You can do a Google search for self-care practices to find some things that you want to do. But make a list of things that you want to include in your self-care practice and just start doing them. Okay. Lastly, I want to also invite you to take the 4-day Show Up For You challenge. And it's 4 days of videos and worksheets delivered right into your inbox every day. And the purpose of the challenge is for you to show up and do the work. So it's an amazing challenge. There's videos that you can watch every day that's going to motivate you to show up for yourself. And you can sign up at befreeproject.com/showupchallenge. So everything that I noted, I will drop the link in the show notes so you can take a look at that. Thank you so much for rolling with me as I took this break, or I took the break for the month of June. I'm glad to be back on the podcast. Make sure if you're enjoying what I'm sharing to rate and review on Apple Podcasts, and also share this podcast out with your friends. So again, snapping a shot of it and sharing it on Instagram stories, on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter. Just tag me so I can see it. And then lastly, I did create an Instagram page for the podcast, and it's called Girl Be Free Podcast. So if you have any questions about the show, or you just want to share your feedback, let me know your self-care practices or what have you, make sure that you're following Girl Be Free Podcast, and you can leave all your comments and everything on that page, and I will be sure to see it because I am running that. So thank you so much for tuning in, and until next time, girl, be free. Thank you so much for listening. Your support means the world to me. Don't forget to subscribe so that you never miss an episode. And if you're feeling really fancy, go ahead and leave a review. Until next time, be free and live.